The hip joint is made up of a ball, the head of the femur, and a socket, the acetabulum. Around the joint is a rim of cartilage called the labrum and a surrounding joint capsule, keeping the femur in place as we walk or run. Most of us go our entire lives relying on our hip joint without any pain or problems. Hip dysplasia can affect anyone at any age. Although it is believed to develop around birth, it may not show symptoms or cause pain for many years. So what is hip dysplasia? Normally, the acetabulum, or hip socket, develops to fit perfectly around the head of the femur. Hip dysplasia occurs when the hip socket doesn't develop properly and is too shallow to completely cover the head of the femur. This can cause the femur to move out of place, called subluxation, and may even become completely dislocated. Sometimes, however, a dysplastic hip won't cause any trouble until later in life. Over time, it damages the labrum and wears down the cartilage, causing hip pain and reduced tolerance to exercise. The good news is that hip dysplasia can be treated in a number of ways. The type of treatment depends on what age the hip dysplasia is diagnosed. If diagnosed around birth, hip dysplasia is often detected through a physical exam, along with an ultrasound. Since it is caught early, a brace, called a Pavlik harness, is often sufficient to keep the femur in place and allow for the hip joint to develop properly. Our team of pediatric hip experts will assist you in putting the harness on and help you learn how to properly care for your baby in the harness. If hip dysplasia is diagnosed later and your child is already walking, it is possible that a procedure will be needed to put the hip joint back in place. This type of procedure is called hip reduction. Your child will either have a closed or an open reduction. To help determine the best treatment, a hip arthrogram is typically performed. During the hip arthrogram, contrast is injected into the hip to better see the joint on an X-ray. If possible, a closed reduction is performed, which means the femur is manually put back in place by your orthopedic surgeon. If, however, surrounding structures such as ligaments and tendons have developed in a way that block the femur from being moved back into place, then a surgery called an open reduction will be necessary in order to clear the path for the femur to return to its proper position. If any bony structures need to be adjusted as well, additional procedures called pelvic or femoral osteotomies, where bones are cut and rearranged to make for a more proper fitting hip joint, may also be performed during an open reduction surgery. With both closed and open reductions, your child will need to be in a type of body cast called a spica cast for a few months in order to keep the hip in place as it heals. Children often adjust quickly to daily activities while wearing the cast, and we will give you tips to help you and your child through this period. Hip dysplasia may go undetected until adolescence or early adulthood, when it often presents itself with pain. Our team of orthopedic hip preservation specialists will order tests, including X-rays, as well as CT and MRI scans, in order to help determine the health of the hip cartilage, whether the labrum is still intact or torn, and decide on the best treatment for you or your child's hip. If non-surgical treatment, such as physical therapy, is unsuccessful, surgery may be necessary in order to relieve pain and to prevent arthritis or further hip problems as you age. This procedure is called periacetabular osteotomy, or PAO. During a PAO, your surgeon is able to rearrange the hip bone so that it grows back in the right position around the head of the femur. At the Child and Young Adult Hip Preservation Program, we have leading specialists dedicated to providing world-class treatment for hip dysplasia from infancy to adulthood and beyond. Our team is determined to give each and every patient a long life with his or her hip, free of pain.